Hi. Angular evolves so fast, and there are so many myths about this framework that were true at some point in time, but nowadays they are not relevant anymore. And in this video, I'm going to share with you top 7 such myths about Angular that people still believe, but they are not true anymore. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmitry Lozhensky, and here you can find a lot of unique and advanced Angular tutorials that you can check out later. But now, let's learn which myth about Angular we can still hear until today. The myth number one, Angular runtime performance is slow. This is false. But why does this myth exist? The myth about bad Angular performance comes from the time of AngularJS, which is predecessor of Angular, and it has been dead for many years already. Things got better in the next major version of Angular, but still it was one of the weakest parts of the framework. Everything has started to change since Angular 17, when were introduced new reactive primitive signals, there were introduced new control flow, and also first attempts to make zoneless change detection mechanism in Angular. Those three components allowed Angular to boost runtime performance so that, according to some benchmarks, the runtime performance of latest version of Angular isn't significantly lower compared to latest version of Vue, and Angular totally outperforms React, so that even the latest version of React 19 that introduces a special compiler, it couldn't drastically change the situation, and React remains with the slowest runtime performance according to this benchmark. The myth number two, Angular has huge bundle size. The myth about terrible huge bundle size of Angular comes from the very first versions of Angular. This is because Angular got this fancy decorator-based syntax that could not be executed directly in the browser. So entire compiler was included into the bundle of your application in order to perform compilation directly at runtime in the browser. This is also known as a JIT or just-in-time compilation, and it bloated the bundle size of Angular apps drastically. Nowadays, Angular code gets compiled at build time before it is shipped to the browser, so we don't have to include the entire compiler into the bundle. The huge role plays also the new rendering engine called Ivy that was introduced in Angular 9, and also the standalone API that was introduced few major releases later. Because of them, a huge amount of code can be tree-shaking so that your application bundle includes only the code that application initially needs. And of course, Angular offers a lot of lazy loading features like routing lazy loading or deferable views that allow you to chop your Angular bundle into smaller pieces and load them later on demand. This everything drastically reduces the bundle size of the modern Angular applications, which is nowadays isn't significantly bigger compared to React with router, forms and other libraries that are essential for every real-life application. So the myth that Angular has a huge bundle size isn't true. Myth number three. Never use the component methods or functions in component templates. Use pipes instead. Frankly speaking, I also believed in it for quite a long time, and I didn't even try to dive into the topic to figure out if it is indeed so dangerous. Actually, it turns out that unless you perform any expensive computation in those functions you call in the template, you are fine. Yes, the method will be executed every time when Angular performs change detection on the component. But if in the method you perform very simple operations like reading the value from the object by key, or if you perform simple logical operations, it happens so fast, it takes nanoseconds to perform, so that it is very unlikely that you will see any noticeable issues with the performance. But don't get me wrong, pipes are still a preferable way to perform data transformation in component templates, especially if this transformation logic is quite expensive and can be reused in many parts of your Angular application. But if it is something simple and has to be used only in one component, then go with the method. It's fine. You can even get a little benefit in terms of bundle size, because compiled pipe generates more code compared to a component method. Myth number four. Always use renderer 2 for DOM manipulations. Why does this myth exist? Back to the history. In the earlier days, Angular was promoted as a multi-platform solution, and renderer 2 was an abstraction layer to avoid tight coupling with concrete platform like browser. And exact use case was when the platform server's DOM was incomplete, the renderer 2 was the solution to make it work. But after the integration of the server-side DOM implementation, also known as a domino, and after the release of the IV renderer in Angular 9, there is no longer need in renderer 2, and the recommended way is to simply use the document injection token for DOM manipulations, which give you the same abstraction layer you had with renderer 2. Myth number 5. Prefer using host listeners and host binding decorators to handle host events and value bindings. It was true for a long, long time, and it just became a myth when the new signal-based API was introduced as an alternative for the decorator-based one. So, as you can currently see from the new Angular documentation, the host binding and host listener decorators exist exclusively for backward compatibility, and the recommended way for host manipulation is the old and almost forgotten host property in the component decorator. I'm pretty sure many of you didn't even know about this, even though it has existed since the very first Angular versions. Myth number 6. MarkForCheck doesn't trigger change detection. It was also a true statement for a long, long time, and it just started to become a myth in the context of the Angular 18 version. Because since Angular 18, MarkForCheck indeed triggers change detection, but in the hybrid change detection mode, which is intermediate change detection mechanism between going fully zoneless. And this hybrid mode is enabled by default in Angular 18. I incidentally learned about this change in one of the threads on my Discord server, which you can join, by the way. It is absolutely for free, and we are already a community of more than 700 Angular developers around the world. So if you want to join our server, our community, then please welcome, scan this QR code right here or follow the link in the video description. Myth number 7. Avoid using ng-deep because it is deprecated. Well, that's really fun. If you didn't know what is ng-deep, it is a special CSS selector in Angular that allows encapsulated component styles to be exposed to the global level. This feature was deprecated immediately after it was released, actually. And the idea was that there will be an alternative feature supported natively by browsers. But because browsers will never implement the feature what ng-deep does, that's why, since Angular 18, well, it was undeprecated. I see it first time, but it is true. You can make sure and go to Angular dev and you will not find any mentions about deprecation of the ng-deep. But despite it was undeprecated, Angular team still strongly discourages the usage of the ng-deep. So use it, but carefully and when you don't have any other choice. But the fact that ng-deep is deprecated is a myth since Angular 18. Another myth is not about Angular at all, but it sounds like it is not possible to learn data science, math, and computer science easily and effectively online. This is not true, thanks to platform Brilliant, which is sponsor of today's video. Brilliant is a place where you can develop algorithmic thinking and learn computer science, math, programming, AI, and many other subjects online. Learning on Brilliant is really easy and engaging because of the hands-on approach, which helps you deeply understand concepts and learn faster. If you want to learn programming or learning a new programming language like Python, you can find dedicated courses and start building programs from the very first day. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 40 days, visit brilliant.org/decodedfrontend or scan the QR code on screen, or you can click on the link in the description. You will also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video until the end. I hope this video was interesting, and please let me know in the comments which other Angular myth do you know, and yeah, maybe I will create a second video about that. If you would like to support my channel and learn more about Angular, you can check out one of my video courses. Or you can support new videos on Patreon, where I also publish exclusive videos about Angular, of course, and from them you can also learn a lot of cool things. And of course, big thanks to our current patrons. Otherwise, once again, thanks for watching. I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next videos.